Hi and welcome. This is Renee once again, welcoming you to this series of lessons that we are doing online. Thank you very much for all your support. And don't forget that the coming week, on June 7th, we're going to have the wonderful presence and music of Emmanuel Trefilio with his bandoneon in our virtual milonga on Sunday. Let me start this lesson by asking you to wear some shoes. This is something different that we're going to do today. And we're going to be doing a few things today. We're going to do, we're going to review what we have been doing with the Molinete and the basic step, but we're going to add a little bit of change of directions. And then we're going to try to develop some exercises that are going to help the ladies to look a little bit different, to have more control of their balance when they're finishing something up. So, with other ado, let me start by refreshing a little bit what we did last week. In last week, I'm going to start by the ladies. We did the basic step, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then we did 5 steps around. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here, you feel the lead of completely turning the direction, and then another set of 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here, you just, once again, wait for the lead of the leader is going to give you, and then finish 6, 7, and 8. Only when the leader finishes the step. If not, we would call that as an anticipation, which is not very good, okay? For the leaders, it was completely the opposite. We start by doing very simple, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and from here I open and I create a space and I invite with my body the lady to come around. I lead the pivot, switching her direction, and another 5 steps. Collect 6, 7, and 8. During this set of steps, we were also practicing a little bit the syncopation, which is something that we're going to do today as well. Now, we're going to put aside what we did and we're going to just focus in what we're going to do today. I'm going to start by the leader movements. Gentlemen, we're going to start with the left leg, okay? And I want you to, we're going to take this exercise for now in 4 times. So it's going to be 1, 2, 3, and the last one, look at my chest because I'm not done here. I'm like in the middle of something. 4. Okay? From here, I'm going to, for now, exit 6, 7, and 8. So, one more time, if I do that, I'm sorry, I'm going to just jump in immediately to the step. So, I go 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8. Why am I doing 4, 6, 7, 8? Because this fourth movement is already putting me in the number 5 of the basic. So here all I have to do is finish 6, 7, 8. That's the reason, that's the only reason why we learn the 8 steps, to like have a pattern that brings us back to this salida. The salida is the exit, okay? So, very simple. When you're doing the exercise of the rebound, 1, 2, 3, you this is not a choice that you can or you cannot. You have to invite your dance partner to come with you. So at some point, my torso is being used as the energy that is bringing her back. Then I'm going to invite her to come forward, okay? So I want you to have a look at what I'm going to do with my chest. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay? That I'm exaggerating a little bit in the posture of my chest, but I want you to always focus in this area, because this area, your torso, is finally the part of your body that is leading her. Okay? So, the follower's role. So, I'm going to try to do the exercises following the 8 steps that we have been practicing in the past 2 weeks. I'm going to take the steps up until the 5th. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. At this point, you're ready to disconnect your right leg and walk 6, 7, 8. But the leader is going to make you go back with the right, rebound. Your leg, you're going to feel how the leader is going to like move you close to him, so to face him. And after that, he's going to keep going on the other side. You don't know what's going to happen after that. But in order to give it a little bit of closure, we're going to try to finish in 6, 7, 8. 2, 3, 4, 5. From here, a rebound step. 1, 2, 3. The number 4 is your pivot. And see, now your left leg is the one walking, right? So at the end, we're going to do 3, 4, 5 again. And we're going to do it all over again. 1, 2, 3, 4. That 4 turns into the 3, 4, 5. The numbers are relative. The numbers, as you can tell, are always changing. Now, I'm going to try to do the same exercise, but I'm going to add a little bit of musicality to my movements. Let me try to do it. And the reason why I'm doing this is because the movement is a little bit more complex. So I want you to like really understand what you're doing. Let's go to the gentleman part. You're taking the 5 steps to the cross. 2, 3, 4, 5. From here, normally what we have been doing is disconnect that leg from the crossing, basically uncross that leg. I'm not gonna do that now. I'm just going to keep her upwards. I'm going to hold that suspension that we were practicing with, and then I'm going to make a rebound step. 1, 2, 3. See how like I'm holding her against my chest, and then I'm going to, the number 4 is the pivot, and look at my feet at the same time that I pivot, I collect. From here, we're going to keep going 3, 4, 5. 3, 4, 5. And I can do, I'm going to move a little bit. Imagine that that's in the number 5. I'm going to do it again. 1, 2, 3, 4. Here, her left leg is hanging, so I can continue 3 with my right, 4 with my left, 5. And from the 5th, it's so very easy to create this syncopation or this change of direction for now without syncopation. 1, 2, 3. As we did last week, I can take my time here. I can, as long as I keep her in that suspension, I can be switching my weight from one foot to the other. She's not going to do that. And then I keep going. 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 3, 4, 5, and then at some point I'm going to finish doing 6, 7, and 8. This exercise, in the way that I am placing it here, see, I'm moving here, I play, I turn around, I go another basic. You all know that when we're dancing tango, we're dancing with the whole group. We're not just dancing isolated, and I'm going to be using just this space. I have to use the whole room because tango is dance in a series of movements. The whole group is moving in a line of dance. So there's always somebody that it needs to be moving forward as I move forward, because this couple in front of me is also going to move forward. Sometimes they might be busy doing something, and you know, I cannot just invade their space. So I'm going to respect that, and I'm going to give them a little bit of time. If I can go back here, I'm going to go back here, and then I'm going to return. But I'm not going to freeze just because I don't have a space. There's a lot of things to do while I am using this spot. The idea is that we don't stop dancing, not even for a second. Now, the first exercise was taking us to do this switch of direction of 180 degrees that we're doubling. We're doing 2 of these, so in reality we're doing a 360 degree turn, one by one. But what happens if I use my other leg? So I'm going to take the same steps, and I'm going to go to the crossing. 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm going to go 1, 2, 3. At this point, her left leg is disconnected. I'm holding up. And if the other couple is ready to come forward, I cannot afford to do 3, 4, 5. So I'm going to do another rebound with my right foot. Meaning 1, 2, 3. And then I finish 6, 7, and 8. That seems very easy to do, but it has its own little complexities. I'm just going to be explaining, gentlemen, this is for you, the right leg turn, okay? So, I'm going forward. I'm using the pillow, so you can tell that the pillow almost doesn't move because I'm moving my lower body first, and then I'm moving my upper body, and as a consequence, her body. 6, 7, and A. In the first movement, what is different that I'm doing from the first movement to the second movement? In the first movement, I am going with my left. I'm going to do it in the middle of the room. And all the time, I'm taking her with me. See, I'm moving my whole body with me. There is almost no disassociation. In this second one, because I'm moving my lower body first, I'm inviting her to switch her weight. I start with my right. She's walking with her left. I do the rebound. See, in this moment when I do the rebound and I do this, I'm forcing her to place her foot on the ground. And then immediately after that, boom, I invite her to come forward. And then her right leg is going to be lingering. Her right leg is suspended. And then I finish 6, 7, and 8. Okay? So if I would be doing this from the fifth to, actually I don't need to go to the fifth, we're going to do it in order to make it more active from the second side. 1, 2, 3, 6, 7, and 8 to finish. For the ladies, as you have just heard, there is a slightly movement that is going to make you feel this movement in a different way. So, from the second step, side, you're going to feel that the leader is doing a rebound, but it's not, you're going to feel his body staying with you and zero energy, and then move you forward. Look at my feet. I'm going to explain this better with at the end of the lesson, but if I move my feet together with, as a unit, as a whole, I'm going to be losing my balance, right? I'm going to, like in the first exercise, I'm going to keep my joints active. Bam! And then here, I'm going to feel like the leader is kind of like suspending me and then immediately invites me to go forward. You have to feel that. You have to switch your weight. That little part when the gentleman is going back and then pivoting, that is a message for your feet, for your axis, to do this from one foot to the other. So you start with your left, one, switch, kind of like, this is a teeny tiny side step. It doesn't feel like a side step. It's like all you have to do is switch your axis from one foot to the other and then walk forward. And at the end, feel how the leader is turning your whole body to place you in the number fifth position. Okay? In the second part of the lesson, I'm going to give you a little bit of a hint about how to move the right leg, but I want you to look at it. I'm not going to explain too much now, but look at that leg at the very end. Side, you go back with the left, you step with the right, you go forward with the left, pivot, 6, 7, and 8. So that would be the first part of the exercise. The exciting part of this exercise is that we can do it, we can mix the first part and the second part, which is the goal of this class today. So now I'm going to go to the fifth position. Gentlemen, this is for you. So 2, 3, 4, 5. The first is the easy one that I don't have to go back. The only one thing I have to do is 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm moving her torso at the very end. And my body is not making any disassociation. And in the second part, I'm going to go with my right leg. 1, 2, 3. And then I finish 6, 7, and 8. Okay? Let's try to do it again. I'm going to keep the pillow a little bit further up away so you can see what is the relationship with my torso. 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3. First, 180 degrees. See how, like, at the very end, I am pivoting very slowly. It's not a quick movement. The left leg of my dance partner is suspended. See how I'm not collecting my feet. I'm holding that. And then I'm going to mix it with the other 180 degree turn. I go 1, 2. See, here is when I am switching her weight. Bam, bam. And then I create the space for her to come, pivot. I cannot do this pivot and keep walking. I have to make sure, look at the pillow. She's walking, I have created the space. And she takes her time to come back to me. I need to wait for her to come back to me up here first, and then keep going. Because of the disassociation, her body is going to always come to you, back to your chest, a little bit earlier than her legs. I don't want you to think too much in her legs. I want you to focus for now in her upper body, in her torso. She arrives here and then you go comfortably, okay? I know that it's very difficult to practice just with a pillow, but for now, I want you to realize all these teeny tiny things that are happening. I'm going to do it one more time. 2, 3, 4, 5. In the first part of the exercise, look at the pillow and my torso. Nothing critical happens. We are together, we're not doing anything. In the second part, however, 1, 2, 3. There's a little bit of, in order to create that space that I want her to use, I am moving, I'm opening my chest and then invite her to use that space. And then I'm bringing her back. I'm not crushing her against me. I am allowing her to come back. I'm waiting for her at the end, and then I keep going. This is a little bit critical for you leaders, because let's say the lady is doing the last part and she's arriving. If you look at my leg, to my feet, please. If you keep going forward, it feels like that. If you don't allow her to arrive with her torso first and do 6, 7, and 8. Okay? So be very, very careful when you're doing that. For you ladies, difficult but not difficult, because difficult in the sense that there is no symmetry in these changes of direction, because the embrace is not symmetrical. If you're the follower, you have a lot of space on your right side, but not a lot of space in your left side. So I always want you to think about that, that this, when you're dancing, you have to not everything is going to be exactly the same on your right and on your left. You can do everything that you want, but there's going to be a little bit of a difference from one side to the other. In this particular case, we go to the fifth, and you're going to feel this. The first part, as I said earlier, is very simple. It's just 1, 2, 3, and then immediately after this, you're going to feel another very energetic step backwards, but then, boom, it's like a suspension that is making you go to the side and immediately again forward, okay? I said that it was difficult and easy. The easy part is that you're not designing anything. The leader is basically guiding you through every step. The thing is that you cannot be proactive. You cannot anticipate, not even one little bit. The moment that you anticipate to this, something wrong is going to happen. So allow the leader, wait for his invite to use the space. Don't just jump in there. I know that I repeat this, as I told earlier to the leaders, I know that it's very difficult practice by yourself, but eventually you're going to be doing this with a partner. But I want you to remember that. Always wait. Always be a little bit behind the leader. Allow that elongation of the movement. So, let's try it again. I'm going to do it with the pillow one more time. The moment the differences in between one side and the other. As I said earlier, in the first one, the leader is moving you with him all the time. There is no, I'm going to do it here. See? There is no difference. The difference is in the second part, he walks one, and you're going to feel how his body is moving a little bit on his left side, and that same left side is going to open. If this is led correctly, your intuition is going to go forward without you thinking or processing what you have to do. Which leg you have to walk with, or how you have to walk. The only thing that I want you to remember is that when you're walking forward, as we saw in the second or third lesson, I want you to try to walk in one straight line. And at the very end, allow that pivot in your feet. I'm going to emphasize that a little bit later in the part of the footwork. So, for all of those that are willing to hear a little bit of the musicality, if I would be doing this with syncopation, I would be probably doing it this is the third week that we're practicing with the music of Riccardo Tanturi, because Riccardo Tanturi has that ability of making things sometimes extremely slow, like Carlos de Sardi, sometimes very elegant, like in this case, like it sounds like Miguel Cabo, and some other times it's so fast and nice that it's just like Juan D'Arienzo. So, first, ladies. Thank you. you can appreciate, although there is a little bit of an acceleration because I'm doing a syncopation in the last part. Bam, bam, bam. I'm not doing it extremely fast. I'm not doing it on my own. I need to wait for the instructions of the leader. Okay, so the musicality is not just the leader's job. You have to have a musicality, but we have to work together. That means that we have to go together in the process of the musicality. If the leader is late, you can fix it a little bit, but it's going to be like an extra effort. For that same reason, leaders, you really have to be with the music. So first slow, then fast. Leader's role with syncopation. Every time, to me, it's like a very elegant move that to wait for my dance partner to do a very nice crossing, allow her to like probably do a little bit of an embellishment, and then exit. That's to me the most beautiful way of work together with a follower. And before we go to the footwork, I want the ladies to look at my footwork when I'm, again, this is going to be a very simple exercise. We're going to do it with the help of the chair. I'm going to place the chair over there so you can see what is happening. For now, I'm going to just do forward ochos, but I want you to emphasize, we did this before, but now I'm going to make you imagine the part where you would like to use this part. My torso is going to be parallel to the back of the chair. And then look at the way I'm going to move my leg. I'm going to try to go with the music in 1, 2, 3, boom. 1, 2, 3. I wait the next beat. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. So the exercise is very clear. For now, it's just for what I chose. But when is this going to match with your dancing of these particular steps? Two opportunities. Let's say 2, 3, 4, 5. We're reviewing this exercise we did a week ago. Molinette. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here, when the leader pivots me to the end, I'm going to do the first part. 1, 2, 3, 4. This is the end. After this, I have to exit 6, 7, 8. No matter what. 6, 7, and 8. So every time that the leader invites you to make a larger pivot, that's when your leg is going to emphasize that movement. It's going to relax. The more that you leave that leg, the foot and the whole leg behind, the more elongation you're generating in your own body. For this exercise that we did today, I'm going to do it. Everything. Two, three, four, five. In slow motion. One, two, three. One, two, three. If you learn how to relax that leg, that little by little, you're going to be connecting this line that I'm talking about. The less that you think about that, and the more you just concentrate in your footwork, as if just your feet would be dancing. See, I'm going to do it wrong. This is not correct. I get to the cross. Can you tell that it's kind of like in a rush because I'm holding my feet and they feel like they're not moving at all, but at the same time, it gives you the illusion that they are moving a little bit too quick, but without any sense. When I take my time and I try to elongate, I can literally feel how my joints go from being soft to being elongated. Even my ankles are feeling that. Boom, boom, boom. So every time that you're working this very simple movement, try to add that exercise in your head before you arrive to the fifth position. You should be doing a nice embellishment and then finish your step. I know that every school has its own way of defining what tango is. A lot of instructors are going to tell you, you don't do anything unless the leader tells you what to do. In my humble opinion, both the leader and the follower need to say something. If I just do this all about the leader, then is like a monologue where the leader is just has the voice. If the lady is doing too many things, again, it's just a monologue and it's all about the follower. The perfect dance is when I say something, you listen, and you tell me something. So, in other words, always think of tango as a language that you're learning. And at some point, you have to have a conversation. You have to listen, and then you have to say something, okay? No matter what your role is, we're having a conversation. We need to know what the other is telling us in order to make something, in order to make sense of what we're dancing about, okay? Well, let's go to the footwork now. Okay, so the footwork, of the first exercise, I'm going to start with the ladies and I'm going to try to do it in a diagonal line so you can see my feet working. The first thing that we're going to try to do is, like we always talk, be in balance, properly waiting for the lead to happen, and we're going to go to the fifth step. One, two, three, four, five. From here, we're just doing the first exercise. I'm going to go one, two, three, four, five. Okay? This is to show you the first part of the exercise where we were just trying to do the turn starting with the right leg. One, two, three, four, five. One, two, three. Three, four, five. Okay? I want you to focus in how I'm using my feet to pivot. Every time that I am pivoting, I'm going to just do it with my left foot. I want you to see I am using the ball of my foot. Okay? I cannot pivot on the behind my pinky toe because that is going to make my ankle a little bit weak. Remember that a few lessons ago, we tried to make sure that that line of your ankle is connected with the ball of your foot. So it's a lot better to be like this rather than this, okay? I'm going to do it again in slow motion so you can see that little part. I'm in the cross. One, two, three. Okay, of course, because I don't have a dance partner leading me right now, there's no energy, so it's very difficult to do the pivot. Or try to sustain that pivot in a longer period of time. However, I want you to see the position of my feet, nevertheless. Okay? When you're doing the second part, now I'm going to do the first part and the second part at the same time. Five. One, two, three, pivot. One, two, three, and then that pivot. In the second part, which is, I'm walking with the left foot, I put my both feet together, and then I walk one more time with the left. I know that you're wearing high heels most of the time, but if you step too much on this side, you lose the ability to do a very nice pivot because your knee is going to be supporting all your weight. The knee is a very weak joint. If you place your leg, I know that it's difficult, but if you walk in a straight line, you wait until you transfer a little bit of weight on the ball of the foot and then do the pivot, you're going to realize how much better your whole body is going to be moving. That is the reason why I was asking you to the exercise on the chair, to practice exactly that. Not to go like this, because then you're killing your pivot. You're killing that nice energy that you're leaving behind and you're bringing it forward, okay? So don't forget that interesting part, which is extremely important when you're dancing. The pivot for you ladies is really something that you can exploit to make your dance look a lot better. Now, when if you're trying to practice this a little bit faster with the syncopation, don't forget. See, the syncopation is not something that I'm going to wait for the leader to activate all the time. You can do it by yourself. I was dancing the syncopation, and then the leader didn't leave that part. But how do I know that I can do that? In right after the second step. In the third, you know if the leader is going to walk fast or slow. So if you feel the very slow pace, after this, I'm asking the leaders to feel more your feet, to feel more your body, to feel more your upper body, to give you a little bit more space. So I want you to use those aspects that I'm asking the leader to create. So be slower, if you have a teeny tiny space, elongate your leg and try to practice with it. See what I'm going to do. Let's say I did the crossing. I'm going to do the first part of the exercise in slow motion. If the leader is pivoting me very slow here, I can okay. So make sure that your movements are not just rigid, and recognize when there is disassociation and when there is not. Okay? I'm going to do that one more time. So to give you in a diagonal line, to give you the chance to see what is happening. Gentlemen, the exercise is going to be, our footwork is not that difficult. However, make sure that your feet start right together. Let's do it as in a diagonal line as well. Whenever you start dancing, make sure that you are correctly leading. Make sure that she is following you, but by switching your weight from one foot to the other, two times. You don't have to be like this 10 times, because that's kind of annoying. One, two, three, four, five. One, two, three. Take your time in this pivot. I'm just going to do the first part. One, two, three. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Okay? If you manage to be patient, one, two, in this part, see how at the end, I mean, at first I am just stepping, but then I allow my feet to pivot. I think I told you this last week. I cannot pivot if my heels are down. That would be a very difficult work. I mean, a very difficult thing to do. You can tell that the floor in my apartment is wonderful. It's treated and it's very danceable. However, not all floors are made the same. So I just want you to realize that sometimes you're going to be stuck if you lift your heels just a little bit, you're going to be able to pivot. So don't be afraid of the pivoting part. See, what I'm going to emphasize that part. I do number five, and I'm turning around. One, two, three. See, here there's not a problem, but then I need to pivot her, so I am going to pivot at the same time. And now we do the second part. One, two, three, and I waited for her pivot. See, by waiting for her pivot, I'm showing you my legs so you can see how I'm switching my weight. I arrive, and then I am pivoting her, I'm switching my weight, and I'm freeing my left. Let's do that one more time. I am taking her to the fifth position, and I go one, two, three, pivot. One, two, three, pivot. I want you to see this. When my weight is on my left foot, my shoulders are still facing my right side. I switch to my right side and my torso is completely in front of my dance partner, is facing forward, and I'm ready to go into that direction. So to me, whatever my feet are doing is a consequence. It is like in combination with what my upper body is doing. Everything is makes sense with my upper body is doing or my lower body is doing, okay? So don't isolate the movement. Another thing that is very interesting to say here, I'm going to do the exercise from the very beginning. As I always have shared with you, there is this chance that you can do a lot of things at the start, and then in the second step, three, four, five, boom, boom, boom. Okay, now I'm just going to share this with you, gentlemen. Ladies, cover your ears. the more you do this exercise, the more women love it. The more they want to dance with you. Look at my footwork, how many times I'm going to do that same exercise that we have been practicing. Let's imagine that I already arrived to the fifth position, okay? So, to tell you the truth, you can dance all night long just by doing this. Now, right now, today we didn't move forward yet, but there is a possibility that with doing this exercise, you can move forward or you can move backwards. It all depends how we organize the movement, okay? But that is going to come a little bit further. What I want you to register today is, and you know, all you have to do is organize your feet and be patient with them. So if you're a beginner and you're trying to do that, to do this exercise, remember, 2, 3, 4, 5, left. You count four times. 1, 2, 3, 4 is the pivot. And then you count another three steps, or another four if you want, and you go forward with the right this time. Forward with the right, back with the left, feet together, four, which is the pivot, and then you finish 6, 7, and 8. That 6, 7, and 8, they happen all the time, and it's the way to exit all the steps. So, one more time, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 7, and 8. Even when you're practicing your footwork doing this, especially in the end, I want you to use the pillow, not on your feet, on your chest, in the embrace, and try to make sure that you have the feeling of what your torso is doing. Your torso is always moving first, for now. So let's say I arrive to the fifth position, and then I'm doing 1, 2, 3. I move my whole body into the pillar. So I'm moving my chest, my feet, everything at the same time. In the second part, I move my torso first. 1, 2, 3. And then look at, see, my embrace is a little bit open, but then I close and I'm ready to go. 6, 7, and 8. Okay? So, try to practice these exercises. I know that they are challenging because this would be completely perfect if you would have a dance partner. If you have a dance partner at home, please try to practice this. If you have any questions, just let me know later on in the milonga that we're going to host. So thank you so very much once again. I hope you enjoyed this lesson today. Thank you for connecting with us, and let's get together in the virtual milonga now. See you in a bit.